This is Scott Whitenkiewicz, the Chief Community Officer here at Imagely. We received a question from somebody in the Imagely community, and I wanted to address this directly, answer this once and for all, so everybody has a full understanding. But let me read you the question first. This question was about an article that we wrote about image compression, image optimization, and image sizes. The question is, after reading a few articles here on image optimization, I'm trying to make sure I understand what I am reading. Can you confirm that this is what the articles say? Number one, if you want to implement digital downloads and print fulfillment and use Adobe Lightroom to upload, then you should upload at full resolution, 100% quality, 300 dpi in sRGB. I'm going to add an extra thing to this. No pixel shrinking. Number two, after the gallery is uploaded, navigate to the NextGEN gallery, manage galleries, and you should resize the images in the gallery to an appropriate size, say less than 1,000 pixels, in a shared hosting environment, right? Understood that there are image optimization applications that can help, but I would like to do this without the additional software. Thanks for your help. First of all, if you're planning on doing digital downloads or print sales, right, print sales using the automated print fulfillment inside of NextGEN Pro, then you do want to upload at full resolution. Those image files, depending on the camera you use, could be between 5 and 150 megabytes. It doesn't make a difference what size it is. NextGEN Gallery can handle it. If you're having trouble uploading large image sizes, that's actually because of your server's limitations and you have to contact your host in order to get past those limitations. It's not a NextGEN Gallery issue, it's a server issue. Especially on shared hosts, they're going to lower the limit by default of how large a file that you can upload. Regarding the first part of the question, you definitely want to upload to NextGEN Gallery, whether it's directed to NextGEN Gallery or from Lightroom to NextGEN Gallery. You definitely want to upload at full resolution, 100%, 300 dpi, sRGB, no pixel shrinking. So if your image is 4,000 pixels at the longest length, upload it at 4,000 pixels at the longest length. NextGEN Gallery will actually back that up, rename the original so it's hidden and safe and not easily accessible. Before you upload your images, go to NextGEN Gallery's Other Options tab. Inside of there, under Image Options, you're going to see a bunch of settings. These are default settings that will happen every single time you make a change in NextGEN Gallery or upload a new image in NextGEN Gallery. You want to make sure that two options are specifically set. The first option is automatically resize images after upload. And we'll get back to that. The second option is back up the original images. Turn them both on. When you have back up the original images turned on, it is going to do exactly what I just mentioned before. It's going to back up that original full size image, that full size 10 megabyte image, whatever it is. And it's going to back it up to a safe file that is specifically used to restore an image, revert an image if you make a change, like a watermark or something you want to revert. Or it actually sells digital downloads and prints off of that original backup. Okay, this is very important. Now, the other option, automatically resize images, is actually what you need to do exactly what was asked in this question. How to resize images and really compress images without any additional plugins or services. If you turn on automatically resize images after upload, no matter if you upload through Lightroom or directly inside of NextGEN Gallery, it is going to take that original backed up image, make a copy of it, shrink it down to whatever size you specify. If it like was said in the question, if you're at a shared host, 1,000 pixels. You can then set the quality of JPEG just like you can in Photoshop. So 70%, 80%, there's your compression. It will make a copy of the image of the backup, the original, shrink it down to whatever you say. Those smaller images are actually what will be displayed to the visitors on your website. They're what people will see when they browse your photographs and even go to buy the photographs or get a digital download. But the digital download or the photographs that they the prints that they get are actually based on that original backup, which means you can even watermark that resized image automatically, mind you, and then have the digital download of the print not have a watermark because you're not watermarking the original backup. Yes, you can do this inside of NextGEN Gallery without any tools, any additional services or software, but you have to make sure that basically three options are set. Backup the original image files, automatically resize the images after upload, and then setting exactly what size you want those images to be resized to. Thanks for watching. And thanks for asking the question. Keep them coming.